If you needed some coins to build that dream team you guys have always wanted, head on over to my sponsor, Buy Madden Coins. They have the cheapest, the quickest, and the most reliable coins on the market right now. Make sure to use code Poodle for 20% off at checkout. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. And today, I'm going to be going over some of the best investments right now in Madden Ultimate Team. Now, these investments are not so much typical card based. It's more based off of the new evolution type system that they have built into this kickoff promo. Now, if you guys know what that means, let's start from the beginning. If you guys don't even know what kickoff means, kickoff is the brand new promo that just came out in Madden Ultimate Team. It's typically, as it stated in the title, the kickoff promo. It's kickoff the year. It typically comes out the first week of the NFL, but it did come out more towards the second week because of Hurricane Dorian down in Florida and delayment with the development team. Now, this usually kicks off the year. It's like their starter program. Nothing too big, not too small, somewhere nicely in between. Am I a fan of it this year? No, but it did come with one decent thing. Now, the only reason I gave this promo crap about this even decent thing is that there's only a few good options within it. And I'll explain everything in a second once we get into it. But pretty much, the way this promo went about this, they dropped four masters. Khalil Mack, DeAndre Hopkins, Richard Sherman, and Aaron Rodgers. Now, where are the rest of the cards? They're all freaking 83 overalls. But they did do something decent with it, although the reason that's only decent is because it only affects some cards. So pretty much the way they did it was they dropped 32 83 overall players, one from each team. Now, each card can evolve, they can boost. So the way that works is that every win that their regular season team gets, I mean their NFL team in real life gets in the regular season, gives them one overall boost. So like, let's say Derek Carr was an 83 overall, and because the Raiders won on Monday Night Football, I'm pretty sure, he's now an 84 overall. So theoretically, they can only cap out at a 93. So their team needs a total of 10 wins. So after 10 wins, the player will become a 93. Now, in theory, the way you'd like to go about this to pick up these cards would be get the cards that are most likely to hit 10 wins the quickest. Now, if you know anything about the NFL, at least half of those probably won't get 10 wins. And realistically, the only ones that will get 10 wins quick are about 3 to 5 teams max. Maybe 3 teams. Because if you think about it, even if the Chiefs win 13 games, right? Even if they win 13 games, let's say they go 13-3. For them to get that 10 wins, most likely they might be like maybe 10-2, something like that. They're not going to go undefeated 10-0, probably. They're probably like 10-2, let's say, and then they finish 13-3. So let's say they're 10-2. That means 12 weeks from now. 12 weeks from now will be about Christmas, just about. Not Christmas, but I mean, I should say December. We'll be about to sell in December. So if you really think about it, even then, the best possible scenario is you get this card like the last week of November or the first week of December. That's like best case. And in that case, the card hit for you and it was a good investment. But let's say another team goes like 10-6, right? And they scrape it out and they scrape that 10th win out to the last game. They were like 9-5, like the Panthers, they go 10-6. That card doesn't get it for 16 weeks. 16 weeks is 4 months from today. So October 14th, November 15th, December 15th, January 15th. By the time it gets to January 15th, the playoff promo started and the normal card going for 93, which at that point, it's still not even horrible. But again, I'm not buying a card for 100K right now to wait till January that just then might only just break even for me. It doesn't make sense for me. Now, you have to go with the bangers here if you really think about it. Now, guys, before we get into this video, before we start anything, make sure to go down below, smack the like button, guys. Get this video to 300 likes. Every loyal supporter, best way to show support. Hit the like button, helps the channel out tremendously. And if you haven't already, make sure to hit the subscribe button, boys. We're like 70 subs away from 8K. Let's hit 8K by today. That'd be greatly appreciated. So every single one of you watching, make sure to hit the subscribe button. You won't regret it. Let's get to 8K. Comment down below any other teams that you think are good investments. I kind of narrowed it down, because although multiple teams will get 10 wins, not all of them will get them the quickest, because the ones that get it the quickest will be the best investments, because they will be a 93 overall card much sooner than others. So we're going over to the auction block, guys. Don't forget to comment down below some teams that you would think would be a good one for this. Now, let's come over to kickoff. So the team I'm going to have to go with first is probably the Patriots, and that's pretty self-explanatory, because they just got Antonio Brown. With all the rape case and everything, if he gets out of that and he doesn't get suspended, they're talking about the Patriots going undefeated. Will they go undefeated? Probably not. Will they come close to it? Quite possibly. Could they go 14-2? Yeah. Will they get 10 wins the quickest? Most likely. So James White, obviously. No one cares about James White. But if he does, he already is an 84, so he's already starting off higher. If he can get to an 80 and 93 in within 12 weeks, By the end of November, he will be a 93 overall that will quick sell for a ton of training. And or you could either see this as a training investment or a coin investment, or you can go for like 250k and you could just sell him. Although I don't know if it being James White will really affect his price, maybe a little bit, but then his training value will keep him right up there. Now guys, don't forget, if you go over to the store, there is a $5 pack. I will go over that later in the video. That $5 pack gives you one of these guys for free. So it's $5, we get the point. So pretty much you could pick James White or whatever other one I say in here, and you can just get that for $5 and hold on to that. You don't have to waste any of your coins. Pretty good idea. Or even better, guys, you take the pack and you don't open it. You hold it for 16 weeks and you open the pack at the end of the 16 weeks. If they allow that, I'm pretty sure they do. You go buy the pack, you hold it for all 10 weeks or whatever, and the player that hits 93 the fastest, you just take him out of the pack. Pretty good idea in my opinion. Now, next on the list, I'm gonna have to go with the Chiefs. So the Chiefs has Kendall Fuller, 90. And the thing about Kendall Fuller, unlike James White, he's actually kind of usable. Like, you could use this on your team as, like, if you're not, like, a god squad. 84 speed, 81 play rec, 81 man, 75 zone, 81 jumping, 84 agility. He's a pretty athletic corner. You could toss him in as, like, your slot corner. And as he keeps progressing every week, you could have a pretty good card to use every week. And then eventually just sell. Because I think the Chiefs will probably go, like, 13-3 this year. I think 13-3 is fair. So I can imagine they'll get it by sometime in December. They're 10 wins. So he'll be one of the earlier ones, too. Now, another guy that I have slotted in here, and he's a pretty good one, too. Because it's Carson Wentz, so he's a quarterback. So you might actually get some use out of him on like a budget squad. So Carson Wentz right here, decent stats off the rip. 84 throw power, 81 throw accuracy short, 81 throw accuracy mid, 85 throw under pressure, 80 throw on the run, 81 play action, and 75 speed, 6'5". I imagine the Eagles will go like 12-4, maybe 11-5. But even then, they're one of the Super Bowl favorites. So if they do go 12-4, they will most likely get to his card sometime around Christmas, around December sometime. So if it's around December, you guys can just imagine that end of November, early December, he'll be one of the earliest ones. And to have a 93 overall Carson Wentz, that'll probably be thrown back into power. I don't know if he'll be thrown back into power option, I don't know. But if he is, probably pretty valuable. So his quarterback stature will keep him up a little bit. And he'll be a 93 overall. And if you guys know anything about how Madden ratings work, typically when it comes to the Christmas promo, last year the Ghost started at a 93 overall and they still went for a lot. Now people were saying that, I get that. But remember, those Ghosts only went for a lot because there was the Blitz promos. Once the Blitz promo was gone, they didn't go for so much anymore. So don't expect these cards to go up a crazy amount, like 400K. But when they first drop, they'll be pretty expensive. Remember, they're a good training investment. 80K, bro, I don't even know what a 93 overall quick sell for. Probably like close to 10K training, right? Am I being dumb? It's like 4K for a 91. So sick. It's probably like 8K. 7 to 8K training. Still, 7 to 8K training for an 89 overall is not bad. 89K is not bad at all. Now, next, this one was hard, but I'm kind of feeling this one's tough. This one's tough because if you look through the teams, right? Steelers after week one, you know, I'm kind of iffy about them. Rams, a little iffy about them too. Now, a team that I really do like, but the only thing that throws me off about them as their division is going to be the Cowboys. So the Cowboys won Leighton Vander Esch, good user linebacker, 78 speed, 82 tackle. Once the stats go up, a big user linebacker. He's tall and typically fast. His stats are suck right now, but the Cowboys should get at least 11 wins. Like, they could go 11-5. I mean, even better, but I can't imagine that they beat the Eagles twice. But if they do happen to beat the Eagles twice, they could easily go like 12-4. So Leighton Vander Esch will get a pretty good outside linebacker card. And last year, he did actually have a 93 overall, I believe, playoff outside linebacker card. So this kind of falls right in line with what he'll probably end up having. So he'll be one of the quicker ones to get it also. So again, not a bad buy with Leighton Vander Esch. Those are kind of my top three. Would be the Patriots, Chiefs, and Cowboys. Now, I've had to go with a few other like wild cards. I mean, the Rams aren't bad. But with the whole thing with Gurley, I know Gurley opened everything up, right? Now, actually, let's go to some sleepers, right? Some sleepers here that could potentially get 10 wins. Now, obviously, the Dolphins and Bills, no. Cardinals, I don't think so. Their team looked horrendous. I mean, Kyler Murray did what he could with the little things he had. Offensive line's too horrendous. I don't think they'll get 10 wins. Janoris Jenkins, obviously, no. The Colts potentially could do it. So for 50K, Darius Leonard will be a good linebacker to even have on your team in general, and he'll be getting upgraded. The Colts and Brissett have the team. They could quite easily get those 10 wins. I wouldn't doubt them. He's a kind of a sleeper pick there. Lions, no. Panthers, I mean, the Panthers should. I mean, Cam Newton looked horrendous last week. Couldn't make a throw to save his life, but DJ Moore's going to be a really fast receiver with an 87 speed. When this car gets like an 87 overall, so after even like 4 wins, this car will be probably a 90 speed plus receiver. I mean, he's pretty, I think that's a beastly pickup right there. DJ Moore, sleeper pick for the Panthers. And he's usable. Jaguars, no. Garrett Bowles, no. Roger Saffold, I don't think the Titans will make it. The Ravens, again, another one. Jimmy Smith won't be a bad cornerback to have on your team. Not to mention the Ravens are looking pretty nice so far with Lamar Jackson and Blake Martinez. Going to be a pretty good user middle linebacker. Obviously, when he gets his stats upgraded. But the Packers, I could easily see them eclipsing 10 wins. That's about it. I mean, the Falcons, too, but that's a middle linebacker. I mean, a middle linebacker, defensive tackle. There's James Conner, but now we're kind of, it's not really sleepers anymore. We're kind of in the 80K range. So I gave you guys my like top three that I think will guarantee to get 10 wins. I gave you some sleepers that are a little bit cheaper, guys. That is about it for the video. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy the video and you've been enjoying the content, make sure to go down below. Hit the like button. Let's get this video to 300 likes. Make sure to click the subscribe button. Let's get this to 8K by today. Turn on the noti bell and comment down below any teams you think that I missed and I should give more love to. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm out. See you guys next video. Peace.